Hello dear students, welcome back to the science class. Dear students, in the previous video class we have started with the second lesson. Yes, what is the name of the lesson we were studying? About animals and their adaptations. Okay, then what all we learned in a previous video? Okay, let us remind here. As you all know that animals are divided into how many groups? They are divided into mainly the two groups. Okay, that is a classification of animals we call. How many the animals are categorized into two main groups here. Okay, depending upon the presence or absence of the backbone here. Yes, depending on the what here? Depending on the presence or absence of the backbone. Okay, animals are divided into two categories here. Yes, vertebrates and invertebrate. Okay, based on the absence or presence of a backbone, okay, animals are divided into two groups. The first one is the vertebrates, the next one is the invertebrates. Then what are invertebrates? Animals without backbone are called invertebrates. Animals who are having the backbone are called vertebrates. Okay. Even I have given the definition of vertebrates and invertebrates also. Animals which have a backbone are called vertebrates. Animals which do not have a backbone are called invertebrates. In a simple sentence, I have given the definition of vertebrates and invertebrates. Okay, and even some of the examples also I have told. Okay, I have explained about the examples also. Okay, animals with a backbone. Who are having the animal? The animals which are having the backbone, fish. Okay, the birds, amphibians, reptiles, mammals, these all are having backbone. Which animals are having backbone here? Fish, birds, amphibians, reptile, mammals are having what here? Backbone. So these animals will come under vertebrates. Then example for invertebrates. Okay, what all we learned? Okay, insects it may be. Again, what we learnt? Insects, crabs, snail and octopus. Okay, insects, then the snail, then octopus. These are the some example for invertebrates. Yes, here you can observe invertebrates, insects, like the name of the insect, grasshopper, it will come. Grasshopper, ladybug, butterfly, these are invertebrate. These animals do not have backbone. So it will come under invertebrates. Animals which do not have backbone are called invertebrates. Example, insects, these are grasshopper. Examples like insects. Okay, grasshopper, ladybug and butterfly will come under insects. Crab, snail, octopus, these are the animals, okay, which will come under invertebrates. Then what are vertebrates? With the animals which have a backbone. Example, fish, amphibian. Yes, what are amphibian also? I told the animals which live on land and even in water, both on the land also and even in water also, these animals will live, amphibians will live. Example, frog. Yes, dear student, the frog, it will live in water also and it will live on land also. So frog will come under amphibian. Next one is a reptile. Okay, example for reptiles are turtle here. Okay, yes, this is a turtle. Then the birds. Birds will come under vertebrates here. Then the mammals. Nothing but a horse. Example for mammal is horse. Mammals are nothing but here. What they will do? They will give birth to a young ones and they will feed with the milk here. So we will call as a mammals here. Okay, the reptiles are nothing but they are having the scales on their body. What are reptiles? They are having a scales on their body. You can observe these are the some of the patches here. These are the scales, nothing but hard covering. It is scales are nothing but hard covering. Okay, these animals will come under reptile here. Next, dear students, we'll see animals that are able to live in a varied habitats are developed different modes of movement. As we all know that animals are living in a variety of habitat here. And what is the mode of movement? How they are movementing from one place to the another place? If any animal want to move from one place to another, then what is the mode that how it is moving? like it may be the breathing, feeding habits and body coverings. Okay, we'll see here one by one. Movements in animals, how the movement, how the animals are moving, how the animals are moving from one place to another place, motion we call. Okay, animals move from one place to another for various reasons. Why they will move from one place to another? Because of the many reasons. In case of a food, it may be, okay, in case of water, okay, why they are moving from one place to another? Animals, because of the climate condition. So they will move from one place to another place. What are the reasons then why the animals are moving from one place to another place? Okay, because of the various reason. Because of the various reason, the animals will move from one place to another. Because of a food it may be, because of the water, and even because of the climatic condition also, they will move from one place to another place here. They move in search of food. As I have told already, in search of food. For food purpose also they will move. For what purpose? For food also, to build or find a shelter. Yes, even they want house here. Shelter is nothing but house. Why they will move from one place to another place? In search of food and to build or find a shelter to live. Okay, they will live in a shelter for shelter purpose also, and to escape from enemies. Okay, some of the enemies will be there. Yes, enemies, because those enemies will harm them. Okay, to escape from the enemies also, they will move from one place to another. What are the reasons why the animals will, okay, move from one place to the another place here? What are the reasons? Because of food purpose, shelter, and to escape from enemies. Remember these points. Why the animals will move from one place to another place? Because of the food, shelter, and to escape from enemies. As these enemies, they may, okay, harm the animals here. Okay, to escape from these enemies also. They have a limbs or other body parts which help them to move. Then how they will move? Yes, dear students, how we are moving? If you want to move from one place to the another place, we are having legs. With the help of legs, we will walk and we will move. Then how these animals, they will move? They have a limbs. Limbs is one part of the body here. Okay, or other parts which help them to move here. Even other parts also are there. With the help of that, they will move from one place to another place here. The ability to move from one place to another is called a locomotion. Then what is locomotion? This is a very important definition. The ability to move from one place to another is called a locomotion. Remember this definition. Okay, to move. What is locomotion? The ability to move from one place to another is called a locomotion. Plants show movements in the form of bending, twisting, elongation. How the plants, they will show, even plants are also the living things. Then how they will move? Yes, with how the movement, how they will show? By bending. Okay, if the plant is there, then by bending. Okay, by bending also these plants will show the movement, so that we have to understand that plant is moving here. Even by twisting also and elongation also. Okay, these are the, here the parts which, how they will move here, the plants. Since they are fixed in a soil, okay, as you all know that the plants are fixed in a soil, they can't move from one place to another. So how the movement is shown in a plants? By bending, twisting and elongation. By these process, the plants will show their movement here. Animals show both movements as well as locomotion. Animals, they will show both movement as well as locomotion. Locomotion is nothing but moving from one place to another here. Movements is nothing but if it is there in one place, they will show the movement also here. Okay, here is the definition of the locomotion. You have to remember this term is very important. What is locomotion? The ability to move from one place to another place is called locomotion. Note it down. Okay. Then movement in a fish. Let us learn about movement in a fish. How the fish, they will show their movement here. Okay. The locomotion in a fish is swimming. What is locomotion then? The movement of the ability to move from one place to another place is called locomotion. Then what is the locomotion in a fish? What is the locomotion in fish? As I have told, the meaning of locomotion, nothing but moving from one place to another. How the fish will move from one place to another? What is the locomotion in a fish? That is a swimming. Yes, you all know very well. The fish will move from one place to another place by swimming in water. Then what is the locomotion in a fish? It is swimming. And it is performed by organs called fins here. Then with the help of which organ? Yes, with the help of a nose organ, we are taking a smell. Then here also, and with the legs organ, we are moving from one place to another place. Okay, but how the fish, they will swim then? With the help of fins. They are having what? They are having a fins here. With the help of these fins, the fish will swim here. Yes, you can observe the fins here. Okay, with the help of these fins, they have shown here, paired fins. The picture of the fish also they have shown here. This is a paired fins, this is a tail, and it is having an eye also. Then this is the upper side is an unpaired fin, and this is a paired fin. Okay, with the help of these paired fins, okay, the fish will swim in a water. How the fish will swim in a water? With the help of these fins. Paired fins and unpaired fins. Okay, here upper side it is unpaired fins and lower side it is a paired fins here. With the help of these fins, okay, the fish will swim in a water. What is the locomotion in a fish? The locomotion in a fish is called swimming. And which organ is it is using which organ? It is using the fins here. The streamlined body of the fish helps it swim easily. Streamlined body is nothing but you can observe the here body. It is having some scales on the body here. Okay, for this we will call a streamlined body of the fish helps it in to swim easily. The unpaired fins fish is the unpaired fins in a fish help it to move forward. Yes, upper side it is having what? Unpaired fins. And lower side it is having a paired fins. Then what is the function of this unpaired fins? The unpaired fins in a fish helps it to move forward, upward, downward. Okay, whereas the paired fins helps it to steer and balance itself in water. Yes, dear students, what is the function of paired fins and unpaired fins? Paired fins, okay, this is the upper side is the unpaired fins and lower side is the unpaired fins are there. Okay, the unpaired fins in a fish, it helps it to move forward also, upward and downward. To move from, if the fish want to move forward, you know what is forward? If you are going front, then it is a forward movement we call. Upside, if the fish want to move upside, then it is a upward movement. And if the fish want to move downside, then it is a downward movement. So the unpaired fins is there here, upper side. These fins helps the fish to move forward, upward and downward. Then what is the function of this paired fins? These paired fins will help the fish to steer and balance itself in water for balancing purpose in water. Okay, these paired fins will help the fish to balance its body here. So paired fins will help in balancing the body. Unpaired fins will helps in, okay, to move forward, backward and downward here. This is about the function of paired and unpaired fins here. The tail and fins help the fish to move forward and change the its direction. Then what is the function of this tail? At the back side it is having one tail. This tail helps the fins to move forward and change the direction. If it is going a right side, if the fish want to change the direction, nothing but a right side, then with the help of this tail, it will change its direction here. If it is going in a left side, okay, if it is going in a left side, if the fish want to turn to the left side, then with the help of this tail, it will turn here. This is all about the fish here. Here you have to remember, first is about a locomotion in a fish. Is a swimming with the help of the fins, and it is having a two fins, unpaired fin and paired fins. Okay, this unpaired fins helps the fish to move forward, backward and downward, and the paired fins helps the fish to balance its body. Okay, then what is the function of the tail? It helps the fish to move forward and change the direction. I hope you have understood about the movement in a fish here. Next we'll see about the movement in a, you can observe the picture here. Yes, the fish are moving here, you can observe, even they are changing their direction also. With the help of those tail, it is changing its direction, and with the help of the unpaired fin, it is moving forward, backward and downward. And with the help of the paired fins, with the help of the paired fins, what it is balancing its body in a water. Okay, then what is the locomotion of a fish in a fish? It is a swimming. The fish will swim in a water in this manner. Okay, you can observe here how the fishes are moving in a water by swimming. How? Today we learnt about the movement in fish. In the next video class we'll see about the movement in insects. Now it's a time for homework, dear students. Here some of the difficult words I have given, so go through these difficult words, read and write 5 times in your rough book. In the next video class again we'll continue with this lesson. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.